Well, hey there, neighbors. Today we're going to talk about the LetPot 4-in-1 hydroponic grow system. This is a system that I really wanted to get my hands on because it kind of just seemed like it was a step above all the other hydroponic grow systems on the market. Do I still feel that way? Let's find out. First off, let's talk about the packaging. The packaging is bright, it's colorful, it comes with some useful information about the product, about the company. Overall, I was pretty impressed with the packaging. When you first pull everything out of the box, you might feel like you're missing some parts. Don't worry too much about it because once you actually open the unit itself, they've neatly packaged everything inside that for you. This definitely saves some space with the packaging. They kind of cram a whole lot of things in there and they keep it in a pretty small box. Once you get that box open, you're gonna find inserts for the plants to go in, the lid with the holes to put the inserts into, the foam plugs for plants, tubing, nutrients, power cord, humidity domes, the unit itself, the light, plant food, user guide, user manual, and a little brochure thing about LetPot. All right, so why did I think that this system was better than other ones on the market? What made me think that this one specifically was any good whatsoever? I think the biggest thing that caught my eye with this is that it refills itself. So you have your unit that sits up on a table or wherever you put it, and then you actually have a water tank next to it or down below. We just kind of used a big tote, and you fill that with water. And as the unit runs out of water, it refills itself. It uses a pump and it sucks some water up into the unit, and as it brings that water in, it's actually mixing it with the nutrients as the water's coming in. This takes some of the work out of mixing the nutrients yourself and dealing with all of that. You just kind of put the nutrients into the unit. Everything mixes for you, it's great. The pump that's actually oxygenating your plant's roots, you can hardly hear it at all. When I first set this thing up, I really honestly thought that it wasn't working, but then when I took the lid off and looked in there, everything was moving around in there just fine. And when I turned the pump off, I did notice a very slight change. And then when I turned it back on, I could hear it kick on, but only because I was listening for it. If you have this thing just set up in a room somewhere, you are not gonna notice that it's running whatsoever. The only time you're gonna hear it is when it gets low on water and it has to pump that water up into the unit. You are gonna hear that pump because that pump's quite a bit stronger. If it gets low on water, low on nutrients, anything like that, it's actually gonna notify you through the app. So it's just gonna kind of tell you like, hey, you're low on water, or hey, there was an error when we tried to suck water up into the unit because there was no water in there. So it will tell you, and same with the nutrients, it's gonna tell you anytime that you're low on anything. I will say that I don't know if it's a bug with my app or if it's just in general, but when it notifies me that something's wrong, it doesn't just send me like one notification. It sends me like 12 notifications all in a row. It just keeps going and keeps going. So I will say that's something that I might just need to figure out in my settings, but it sends me so many notifications every time I'm low on anything like that. When I am low on water, it notifies me. It says, hey, you're low on water. And then it just automatically refills itself with the tote that I have below it. It's pretty nice. One thing you'll notice as soon as you get the unit is it has a lot of holes on the top for a lot of different plants. And this is great for something like lettuce, which is what we've been growing in it. But for me, ideally, I would wanna grow something like peppers. So if I wanna grow peppers, I have to figure out something to plug all those little holes. I did hear that LetPot came out with something that either has two or three holes on the top, specifically for some bigger plants like that. I wasn't able to find it on their website, but it is something that I heard that they have. So that might be worth looking into at the time that you are watching this video. All right, one thing I do need to call out real quick in the instructions here. When it's when you're going through the instructions and you're going through step by step on how to set this up, I'm pretty sure I didn't read this wrong. I'm pretty sure I went step by step with the instructions. It had me mix the nutrients, it had me put the nutrients into the unit, and then at some point after that, it actually had me put the water line that brings the water up to the unit, it had me put that in after I put in the nutrients. Well, the issue with that is to get that water line in, you have to tip that unit all the way over to be able to access the port down there on the bottom. And when I did that, I spilled half my nutrients all over my desk here. That wasn't very fun. So no matter what the instructions tell you, make sure you're putting that water line in on the bottom before you're actually putting the nutrients into the unit, or else you're gonna end up with a mess wherever you're doing this at. The light that it comes with seems pretty standard compared to other hydroponic systems. It will grow pretty much anything that you want, but it's not some crazy super high-end light. It does have a telescoping pole on it and you can raise it pretty high. There's not a whole lot of things that are gonna grow out and around that, especially in a system that size. So I do like the telescoping pole that's on it. It makes it really easy to raise and lower that light based on where your plants are. Another thing I really do like is the light itself just kind of unplugs and you can pull it away. So if I want to use my high-end grow lights that I have in my plant room, I could just pull their light out and put the unit underneath my grow lights, and I can grow anything that I want in there. So that's another thing that's really awesome about this unit, is you're not kind of tied down to the light that they give you. Yes, the light that they give you is great. It's going to grow more or less whatever you want, but if you want to grow things better, you can grow them with your own lights just by unplugging theirs. The nutrients that come with the unit, they are, I think they're powder that are inside these two little bottles. You add 100 milliliters of water into each bottle, you shake them up really good, and then you add that to the unit. So make sure you shake it up really well, make sure everything is mixed really well, dissolved in there really well, and then you can put the nutrients into the unit as long as you've put the little water line into the bottom first. Remember that step, don't forget it, because you'll have a mess just like I did. Okay, so your nutrients are in the unit, your water line is hooked up. The next thing you're gonna need is some kind of reservoir, some kind of water reservoir. For us, we ended up going with a pretty large Sterilite tote. It's just a clear tote, and we filled that with water. And what this allows us to do is have a really large reservoir of water that will keep refilling our unit. And I know you're probably thinking, well, Brandon, why do we need to get this whole separate thing of water? Shouldn't it just come with the unit? Technically, you don't need to have the whole separate water storage thing. You can put it in manual mode, and this is gonna allow you to control everything. It's not gonna be pulling up or sucking up any water from any other storage area. This is just something extra that they give you if you wanna use it, and I think it's great, and you probably should use it, because a lot of these other hydroponic systems don't have this. It doesn't allow you to do this. Take full advantage of it, because it's great. Take some extra time and just go to your garage, find something, find a bucket, find a tote, find something to put water in, get it filled up with water, and get it next to your unit. Once you're there, ready to go, you turn the unit on and you turn it into auto mode. As soon as you turn it into auto mode, it's gonna turn that pump on and it's gonna start sucking water from your container into your unit. When I did this, I had the lid off of the unit because I wanted to show and get some video of the water coming in. It might not be that smart for you to do the same thing, because it does splash. The pump coming in is relatively powerful, and it will kind of splash around and make a little bit of a mess. It's gonna take a minute or so. It's gonna slowly fill up. It's gonna mix those nutrients together. The circulation pump is gonna turn on. The whole unit is gonna start turning on, circulating, and working those nutrients in. Now that we've got the water in the unit, we've got everything set up, ready to go, we need to start getting ready to get our plants planted. So first thing you wanna do is take your little white inserts that the plants go into and put all of your little white inserts into all of the little holes on top of that unit. The next thing you're gonna do is take the little brown sponges that they gave you and put those into the white inserts that you just put into the unit. If you're familiar with hydroponics, this is all gonna make perfect sense to you. If you're not familiar with hydroponics, you're about to be. The way this is gonna work is we're gonna put little seeds into the tiny little holes that are in these brown sponges. The brown sponges are gonna soak up some of those nutrients down below. It's gonna get the seeds moist, and then the seeds are gonna sprout, the roots are gonna go down into the system, and it's gonna grow better than anything you've ever grown in your life. Which leads us to planting the seeds. We are doing three different types of lettuces here today. We're gonna plant more than one seed in every single hole. What this is gonna do is it's gonna help you with your germination rate. If you just put one seed in every single hole, a lot of times you're not gonna get one of those seeds to actually germinate. So what you wanna do is you wanna put 2 to 3 seeds in every single hole, and this is gonna be kinda go along with anything else that you're gonna grow in this system, whether it be lettuce, peppers, doesn't really matter. Once you have all of your seeds inside of your little holes, you're gonna wanna take the little humidity domes that they gave you, which are super awesome, take those little humidity domes and put them on top of every single hole. What this is gonna do is it's gonna help regulate the temperature of your little seeds in there. It's gonna help regulate the humidity. It's gonna give those seeds the perfect environment so that way you have a better chance of germination. At this point, technically you don't need your lights on, but I think I was just a little bit overexcited and I got my lights and everything turned on. And you can either do this manually, just kind of on the little display there, or you can do what I do, and I ended up using the app quite a bit. So real quick, we're gonna go through a couple things on the app. The app is pretty simple and easy to use. I'm just gonna go through a couple things and just touch on those really quickly. Okay, so I'm getting the app open here, and right off the bat, as you can see here, I've got insufficient nutrient in planter. So I need to add some extra nutrients to it. I already have the nutrients, I just need to put them in there. I never changed mine off of Celsius, so you can see it shows you the temperature of the water that's in there. It shows you the water level that we're at right now. And honestly, right now the water's getting kind of low, and here pretty soon the pump is gonna kick on just automatically and refill that water, which is great. Right here, it shows how many days I have had those planted, and it shows how many hours a day that they're getting light, which is pretty awesome. You can change the LED mode to flowers and fruits or vegetables and spices. So right here, it shows when it turns on, when it turns off. It shows the LED brightness level. We have it set to auto refilling water and nutrients. cycling pump. The cycling pump is just going to keep the water moving inside there to make sure your roots have good oxygen. That's pretty much everything that's on the app, but it's everything that you need. There's more inside the unit itself. If you get onto this display, there's a whole lot of really in-depth things you can go into. But for the app, that's everything that you need. And I've actually used the app more than I've used the unit itself. And after a few weeks, you should have something that looks like this. This is what our lettuce looks like after about a few weeks. It's growing really well. It's thriving. It's extremely healthy. Everything is exactly how it should be. At the same time as I've been growing this lettuce in the hydroponic system, I've also been growing lettuce in soil in my plant room. And the difference between the two is pretty wild. The stuff in the hydroponic system is just out of control at this point. It is completely exploded. The plants are actually overgrown at this point, and we can't keep up with eating it. It's just really out of control. I love it. And seeing the contrast between the soil plants and the stuff in this hydroponic system, it really does just show me how well this system is growing these plants. So now that I've had time to really settle into this thing, what are my final thoughts? How do I feel about this unit? Would I recommend it to people? Is it something that I actually enjoy and that I'm gonna use past this video? I'll admit I was a little frustrated with the setup, and it's only because of that little water line and plugging that in and just putting the nutrients in first and making that mess. That could have been on me. It could have been me just not paying attention. And I'm sure it's much easier if you do it without putting the nutrients in first. That was probably my only frustration with the setup. Other than that, the setup went really smoothly. It was really easy process. I think that this system unlocks a lot of potential with kind of hands-off hydroponic growing, with still being able to stay up to date with your grow, even if you're not in the same house or the same state as your grow. You can still keep track of it. So yes, it's hands off, but you can also make it as hands on as you want it. And for someone like me, I'm probably gonna get in there and start messing around and tweaking things and really getting some hands on grows in that. That'll be with peppers instead of lettuce, but there's something I'm excited about. So I really am excited to kind of dig into this system more than I already have. So do I recommend it? Yeah, I definitely recommend it. It's a little on the pricey side, but for what you're getting, it's worth it. It's a really intelligent system. It comes with a lot of features. It comes with more than what most hydroponic systems are ever gonna give you. I will continue to use this past making this video. I really have enjoyed it, and I'm gonna really experiment with some peppers in there. If you're interested in getting one of these, or at least going to the website, checking them out, go down in the description below. There's gonna be some links there, so go click on those and check them out there. And if you enjoyed this video here today, go watch this video right here. This video is gonna be a different grow system called Click and Grow, and it's not a hydroponic system, but it is a modular type of system. And it was honestly a really cool system, just a little different version of what we talked about here today. And if you enjoyed something like what you saw here today, you might enjoy that too. So go ahead and go check that video out, and I will see you there.